Hey guys, what's up everyone? Welcome to Young Titan World. I hope you guys are having a fantastic day. Today we're going to be talking about the finale to Yu Yu Hakusho. Now, Yu Yu Hakusho was supposed to be the anime, the, you know, Netflix adaptation of an anime. And boy, did I start off with rousing comments of absolute adoration and love for the anime that came out as a show. Now, the show actually comprises of 5 episodes, all of which I'm assuming is packed up with everything that we see and know from the anime. Now, whilst I am not yet an expert at watching Yu Yu Hakusho the anime, I can say for sure that I'm done with the Yu Yu Hakusho Netflix adaptation. And I gotta tell ya, the fact that they were able to do all of that, you know, like, put every single thing that was in the anime into an actual into an actual TV show is just one that I admire. So you've already heard the story before about a kid who almost died. He comes back and he's now a spirit detective, goes around trying to solve the mysteries that, you know, revolve around the spirit dimension and the fact that the bad guy wants to tear a hole in space-time so he can invite the demons over from their side of the world and so that they can wreak havoc and restore a new kind of world order or something like that. Usually the usual villain MO, you know, so that's really what goes on with that kind of style. And you know, there are different sides. They show us Genkai, who is supposed to be the master of the kid, you know, the kid who never changes his uniform and basically just go around trying to master his spirit gun every place he finds himself, even though we realize that, okay, it's not that difficult to do it, and we're basically dragging it out. Now, with anime, I'm assuming, with anime, there are so many parts of it, you know, it's like there are so many episodes, and I'm not thinking that it ended all in 5 episodes with the anime, so I'm guessing things that would have been stretched out in the anime were packed all into the fight scenes and everything that happened within the TV show, which I still admire because everything still seemed like it was legitimate in its own way. Although you can still see the sense of anime existence in that. But I guess what didn't, everything ended with a bang. I loved the bad guy and the fact that, you know, he had his own honor and code and blah, blah, blah. His CGI looked terrible though, but I mean, yeah, what'd you get? There was a guy who had a gigantic axe, and I'm sure that must have been easy to draw, but having to do all of that using actual CGI, and the fact that someone is gonna be on set carrying a gigantic, axe. I'm sorry, I saw a cat dead. Sorry, I think I'm just not. So, yeah, I guess it's basically so much harder to get all of those scenes look right. And it's hard not for it to look weird. But then again, it is an anime and it's okay. But I guess the one thing I didn't really get was the final scene. In the final scene, Genkai gets to meet the bad guy, right? The big bad who was taken down by her new student. And you know, she was talking to him and, you know, he's already made the decision. He's walking down the stairway to hell. It should seem normal at that point. But then they CGI'd the grandma's face to look younger. And I'm like, hold up. Why did you do that? Why don't you just get the younger version of this woman and just put her there and make her say her lines? Better yet, get someone else to put on a freaking pink wig and do that. But why do you have to make it freaky grandma trying to look young? It just looked so weird and it kind of put me off when it was supposed to be like a wholesome ending and everything. And then I was just worrying about the CGI. It's like, oh my God, the CGI looks so terrible right now. But yeah, I mean, there are so many spots that the CGI did look terrible. But honestly, I don't think you can blame me because they tried their best. The fact that they made the spirit gun look so cool. The fact that they made the bad guy look believable. I mean, I have not seen anyone that jacked up before. But I'm assuming that it looks like that. Nah, it doesn't look like that, okay? The guy didn't even look close to Sam Corey or whoever it is that's so jacked up and makes TikToks. I don't know. All I'm saying is that it ended 5 episodes, an entire season 1. I'm guessing there's going to be a season 2, but I don't know. Might have to check it out. But you guys can also check it out, too. And please, subscribe to the Young Time. Subscribe to the YouTube channel, as it helps us grow and it helps you, or it helps us to reach more people like you, people that actually want to listen to this kind of stuff, you know. But thank you guys so much for listening. We reached 47k, which is unbelievable already. I guess you might have seen the recording that I made about the 40k, which is also a lot. But yeah, with technically all that has been going on, I really do appreciate the attention and the love that the channel has been getting. And I'm actually grateful. I'm grateful that you guys have been there. And I really do love you guys. And I hope you take care of yourselves. Until the next one, I hope you guys have a fantastic day. Till next time. Bye.